market sentiment may have picked up in 2014, but that's not translating into fresh rush for capital. That's the word coming in from the MD and CEO of National Stock Exchange, Chitra Ramkrishna. Many sat down with Chitra on capital appetite, retail investor sentiment, and much more. Here's a slice of that conversation.
It's early days, and I think 14 has definitely seen a lot more positive sentiment. We're not really seeing green shoots on capital raising yet, but I think if this consolidates into a greater investor interest, surely we'll start seeing that flow of capital raising coming into the market. This CPSE ETF, for that matter, garnered a decent amount of subscriptions, which is a good sign.
Retail participation has been a big problem. I don't think they've come back since the 2007-2008 time. What is the sense that you are getting? How has that whole investor community changed?
See, I'm always a votary that we must get direct retail participation after we get indirect retail participation. And I've said this many times, that we must first see a good amount of retirement monies coming into the market, whether it is through the funds. For example, you don't have any of the PF monies really coming into the market still. There is a life cycle. It doesn't mean that we want all the retirement money fund managers to start investing in stocks tomorrow. But there are passive investment vehicles which are less risky, more cost optimal. And that's the way in a lot of markets they have really started, wetting their toes and understanding the market and getting into a more risk mitigated kind of a participation in the market. So you have ETFs today. ETFs today in many of the markets are perhaps one of the best vehicles, passive management vehicles, which are also cost-wise very optimal. So I see the play as really first provident fund retirement monies being able to come into the market, so which is indirect retail participation. Of course, direct retail participation should happen. That can also happen through the ETF route. And subsequently, we sort of move them up into more sophisticated and products that require active management on a day-to-day basis. So when markets are what they are, retail will follow. You first need this.
But you know what also we've seen in the past runs that we've seen in the market, there's a herd mentality. The moment the markets start going up, everybody comes in, and normally, come in when the markets are the peak. Even that's not happened right now. So there is a wait and watch that you're generally seeing. Is that what you sense?
But that is not, it is not at all counterintuitive. That's the way it would be, because even the large investors have rather followed a cautious approach in the last couple of years or so. It is not at all, I would say unnatural for that kind of a response. But more importantly, even in the best of times, the amount of retail participation we have seen in India is a small proportion of total savings.
Sure.
So my take is that we must first look at widening the breadth of retail participation.
Talking about that, NSE has been launching a lot of interesting products. ETFs are one of them. You had the interest rate futures. What's the response been like, and what's the pipeline looking?
So we've done a couple of very interesting products this year, and new asset classes. So for example, ETF is of course the mainstay. In the capital market, the way we want to bring the depth and the breadth in the market will be through more ETFs and more distribution of these ETFs, and a lot of effort and investment needs to go into that. But the new asset classes are really fixed income. So the NSE bond futures, the NBF products which has been launched, very good feedback from the market. So it's really the kind of product market wanted. So RBI, SEBI have, the product approval that they've given is really what the market wants this time. I see that that product has a lot of potential. All products take time to grow. And we really can't be in a hurry on that, because you want to put the fundamentals in place. So you want to broad base the participation. You want all kinds of participants to come in.
The U.S. markets, everybody in the U.S. and the developed world is talking about Flash Boys, this book that has been written by a journalist on the whole algorithm-driven trading that's been happening, and how that's kind of skewing the trading and controlling trades. What's your own take on that? Because it's really what the big boys are playing with right now.
Well, it's one perspective. And I'm sure you'll find another book very soon which gives the other perspective as well. So, you know, the whole speed, algorithm, latency world is still very young. And enough research will only give us true insights. Otherwise, it's a lot of perception.
But that's happening in the Indian context also. So my point is that given the fact that it has such huge volumes driving it or behind it, what are the risk measures that you can take to ensure that there isn't a flare-up?
You know, I think in India, SEBI, in fact, took a very nuanced approach from the beginning. And in the early days when when SEBI put out the entire framework for risk mitigation, we were one of very few countries which had that kind of a risk mitigation framework and an approval framework for algorithmic trading. At that time, I remember that a lot of the Western world was very perplexed as to why do regulators need to put these kind of parameters and so on. But within very few months, ISCO, Australia, many other jurisdictions followed and sort of gave similar framework. So I think in India, we are very much cognizant and aware of the fact that we need to track the risks that are arising and put them as safeguards up front, which exchanges and others will obviously be responsible for enforcing. You know, it's a continuous journey. I don't think you have one circular out, it means you've got everything.